Hey, hi, welcome back. Today we do February March 2020 question number 2, paper 2, question number 2. First, we read the question. Always read the required first. Always read the required first. First, required. Prepare the purchase ledger control account. What's purchase ledger control account? It's actually trade payable control account. Okay, prepare purchase ledger control account for GHB Limited for November 2019, balance up the account on 30 November 2019 and bring down the balance on 1st December 2019. Okay, then we read the question on top there. GHB Limited maintain a full set accounting record and prepares monthly control account. The following information was provided for November 2019. Then they give you purchases ledger control account balance. They give you the balance, but they don't know how much the balance. It's okay. Later we'll calculate that. Okay, we don't know the balance. Later we'll calculate that. Purchases journal. Okay, I'm going to highlight any information that related to a purchases control account first. Okay, purchases journal. Yes, it's related to purchases ledger control account, and purchases return also. Yes, cash. Cash purchases, we don't record inside the purchases ledger control account because cash purchases is not related to trade payable. Because the guy come, we buy and then we straight away pay. So there's no trade payable here. So cash purchases, no need to record here. Commission receivable also no need to record here. Cash discount received, yes. Cash discount received is related to trade receivable. It is 650. After that, cash allowed. Cash allowed is related to trade receivable. Cash allowed, yeah, discount allowed is related to trade receivable. So don't need to care. And then check paid to trade payable. Yes, it's related to trade payable. Sales ledger contra, yes. Okay, contra, we record in the sales ledger control account. Interest charged by trade payable, yes, it's related to trade payable. Check refund to trade payable. Refund to trade payable also we record here. After that, they gave you the balance on 13195. Is a balance CD. Like how I know balance CD? Because it's November. November, last day of the month, is a balance CD. Okay, we will do inside the purchases ledger control account. I'll start with the year. Straight away, I write the year 2019, and here also 2019. Okay, there's a balance. Trade payable is liability. Trade payable is your liability. Okay, liability increase will be credit side. Balance BD and increase I record in the credit side. Decrease and balance CD I'll record in the debit side. So I'll start with balance BD. What is the date? November 1, 2019. I write here balance BD. It's your liability, so your balance BD will be in a credit side. How much is your balance BD? I don't know. Okay, because the question didn't tell me. So I just write balance BD, leave it empty first. Leave it empty, and then you continue to do other things. Later, balance up to calculate this. After that, I got purchases journal. Purchases journal will purchases journal mean credit purchases. Credit purchases will increase the trade payable. If it is an increase the trade payable, so we go credit side, we write how much. On the November 30, I write here purchases. My purchases is 14,200. Okay, after that, next one is purchases return. Purchases return will reduce the trade payable. So will be in a debit side. The date will be November 30. Remember this, for purchases ledger control account, balance BD will be first day. Other than balance BD will be last day. So here I write purchases return. My purchases return is 1160. 1160. After that, I continue next one. Next one is discount received. If I receive a discount, my trade payable will reduce. If I receive discount, my trade payable will reduce. So trade payable reduce will be in a debit side. So I go debit side, I write 650, and then right here, discount received will be in a debit side, 650. After that, the next one is check paid to the trade payable. If you pay to trade payable, how much that I owe will be reduced also. So will be reduced means will be in a debit side. So I go debit side, I write 11420. The amount, the details here will be bank because it's your check. Okay, next one is sales ledger contra. Sales ledger contra, don't care if it's sales ledger contra or sales purchases ledger contra. Contra will record in the both ledger. Contra will record in the both ledger. So in a reduced side, the reduced side for trade payable is debit side. So I go debit side, I write here 250. You can write here sales ledger, or you can write contra. You can write contra also acceptable. Contra and also sales ledger, either one also can. Okay, next one is interest charged by trade payable. If we charge, if the guy charge us, how much we owe will be increased. How much we owe will be increased. So will be in a debit side, 95. I write here interest. Okay, next one is refund. Check refund from the trade payable is 330. So refund will be debit side or credit side. Whenever the guy pay me, I reckon in a debit side. Okay. When the guy will be refund? Whenever the guy overpaid. Whenever the guy overpaid here, I need to minus this. You want to minus me? Minus this means you need to add back the figure. Add back the figure means it will be in a debit side. So refund will be in a credit side. Sorry. It will be in a credit side. So we go credit side. 330, we write here bank. In a bracket, if you want, you can write refund. Okay, he actually, the guy overpay here. Whenever overpay, we over minus. Whenever the guy overpay, we over minus. Then we get to know we are overpaid, then we refund back. When we refund back, we will add back the number, add back the amount. Okay, next one will be balance CD. Okay, balance CD liability. Okay, a trade payable is your liability. Liability balance CD will be debit side or credit side. Okay, you follow the Adam wants eat large chicken rice. So your asset withdrawal expenses will be debit side. Liability, capital, revenue will be credit side. Whenever increase or balance BD, we follow this. Whenever decrease or balance CD, we will exchange them. So now this is liability. Your trade payable is liability. Liability balance CD, you will exchange. So it will be in a debit side. Okay. Whenever you have a problem, which one is debit, which one is credit, use this one. Okay. What is this? Adam wants 8 large chicken rice. What is this? Asset withdrawal expenses is a debit group. Whenever increase or balance BD will be debit. Liability, capital, revenue, credit group. Whenever increase or balance BD, credit. Whenever decrease or balance CD, will switch their house, will switch. So now liability balance CD will be in a debit side. So I go debit side. I write here balance CD. My balance CD will be 13195. After that, do you see any other thing? No, that's it. Now we balance up. Okay, how to balance up? See which side bigger? I'm very sure your debit side is bigger. So we total up the debit side. I total up, I use the calculator and calculate. I get 26,675. The same amount you write here. 26,675. You take this minus, 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 and then now I will get a balance BD. Normally, question will give you the balance BD. We will calculate the balance CD. But this question, here they didn't give the balance BD, but they give you balance CD. So work from the behind. Huh? Okay, now my balance BD will be 12,050. Can I stop here? No, you cannot stop here because if you have a balance CD, this balance CD need to transfer to balance BD on the next day. December 1, balance BD. My balance BD will be 13,195. Then only you get a full mark. Always remember the balance CD must transfer to balance BD to get extra another one mark. Okay, this is how we do the purchases ledger control account. We are done with the answer A. We'll get 9 marks for this. Then we continue. Next question. Next question is, a delivery vehicle was purchased. I read the question. A delivery vehicle was purchased by check during November 2019. State two reasons why the purchases of delivery vehicle is not recorded in the purchases ledger control account. Okay, wait. If you purchase delivery vehicle is your non-current asset. Okay, delivery vehicle is your non-current asset. And normally in your purchases ledger control account, which account we record in the purchases ledger control account? Okay, what are the accounts that we record in a purchases ledger control account? In a purchases ledger control account, we record all the trade payables. Only the trade payables we record in the purchases ledger control account. What is a trade payable? Trade payable means the guy who we buy goods on credit. We buy goods on credit. Goods on credit. Then only we will call that guy is my trade payable. So this delivery vehicle, is it a goods? No, it's not a goods. Okay, and another thing, do you buy on credit? No, you buy on check. If you buy on check, so it's not a goods, it's not a credit, so we cannot record in a trade payable account, which is the purchases ledger control account. So the reason is, the first reason I would like to write here is the purchases ledger control account does not include non-current assets. Does not include non-current assets. Or you can say capital expenditure also. If you want to write a capital expenditure also, can. Okay, first thing. Okay, second reason, maybe I want to talk about goods. I want to say the purchases ledger control account only includes purchases of goods for resale. Okay, if you want to continue, resale on credit also can. You can write resale on credit. Okay. Or another point, you can say the purchases ledger control account only include transaction relating to trade payable. You get 1 mark also. But I don't enough space to write. I give you these 2 marks. Okay. Next one. If you got any question, you can ask me down there. I will reply. Question C. C1. We read the C1. State the most appropriate method of depreciation for the new delivery vehicle. Okay, let's talk about method of depreciation. Okay, method of depreciation. We have method of depreciation. We have 3 method of depreciation. First one, we have straight line method. Another one is reducing balance method. Another one is revaluation method. We have 3 method. Okay, straight line method. When we use straight line method, whenever you receive the same benefit, you receive the same benefit throughout the throughout the useful life of the MCA. Okay, you have a receive a same type of benefit. Example that I can give you is maybe furniture. Furniture. The first day I buy the furniture, until the last day also, I'll use the same. I get the same benefit. Okay, next one is reducing balance method. Reducing balance method. Okay, for the reducing balance method, whenever we receive higher benefit in the early useful life. Okay, whenever we receive higher benefit in an early useful asset on of MCA. Yeah. Okay, example, yes, we can use computer. Example, computer. Okay, when the early years of the brand, whenever it's brand new, the benefit that we receive from the computer will be very fast. We can use it for more things. But whenever times goes on, okay, the computer may be lagging. Okay, the benefit that we receive will be slightly reduced whenever times goes on. Okay, the last one is revaluation. Okay, revaluation. The third method is revaluation. Whenever revaluation will use whenever it is not practical or it's not practical to keep detailed record. Okay, whenever it's not practical to keep a detailed record of MCA, then we will use revaluation method. Example is loose tools. We use revaluation method because it's not practical to keep a detailed record of the loose tools. Okay, now we have three methods. What the question asking, we go back to the question. State the most appropriate method depreciation for the new vehicle. Okay, new delivery vehicle. Okay, can you think this delivery vehicle will give you the same benefit? Is it give you the same benefit or higher benefit in the early, and then when times goes on, the benefit will be reduced, or it's not practical to keep a detailed record? So of course, revaluation is no, it's not. Straight line. The first year of I buy the delivery car, I can use for delivery vehicle, I can use for more deliveries. Okay, when times goes on, after 5 years, after 10 years, do you get the same benefit from the delivery vehicle? Actually, no. So straight line also cannot. So the best answer will be reducing balance. So the answer here will be, we write here, reducing balance method. Reducing balance method. Okay. Now state three reasons for your answer. State three reasons for your answer. Okay, we'll state lah. Okay, first one is you can talk about the benefit lah. Okay. Most of the benefit of the asset is gained in the early years. In the early years of the useful life, we gain more benefit. Okay, next one is why we use this. You can talk about net book value. You can talk about net book value. The net book value, the net book value is more likely to related to the amount which will be which will be realized on sale. Okay, so what, you know what's net book value, right? Net book value means you take your cost minus with the accumulated depreciation. Okay, so if you use the straight line method, maybe your net book value will be not related, or it's the different will be higher. The different will be higher with the realized value. Realized value means the whenever you sell, you get the value. Okay, so number three, you can talk about. More depreciation. We can talk about the more depreciation. Okay, more depreciation is charged. More depreciation is charged in the early years of its life. Okay, the reason why it is related to this actually. Okay, whenever we receive more benefit in the early years, so that's why I'm choosing this. Whenever we receive more benefit in the early years of the usage, so I will depreciate more in the early years of the usage. When the benefit reduce, the depreciation also reduce. If you choose straight line method, the depreciation will be same only every year. But if you choose the reducing balance method, the depreciation amount will be reduced every year. So whenever I get more benefit, I will charge more depreciation. Make sense, huh? Okay, next one. We do the next question. Okay, question number 2A is about purchases ledger control account. Question B is about depreciation. B and C is about depreciation. And question number D, they talk about we need to read and understand. Okay, they talk about what? Let's read the question. The director of the GHB Limited are planning to finance major expansion of the fleet of delivery vehicle. 250,000 will be required for the expansion. The director are considering whether issue additional ordinary share or obtain a long-term loan. Oh, this is something like they related to ordinary share and a long-term loan. Okay, the question is actually asking, they want to do a major expansion on the vehicle. So they have two options. Option number one is they sell the ordinary share to the public. Okay, then we get the thing. And then another one is they take a loan. So remember, your ordinary share, if you take ordinary share, it's your capital. Ordinary share is your capital. If you take a long-term bank loan, that one will be your liability. So what the question asking, advise the director of which these two method of the finance more appropriate. So you need to choose one. Okay, justify your answer. One advantages and one disadvantages of each point. So they gave you how many marks? They gave you 5 marks. So 5 marks, how to divide these 5 marks? You explain about the option one, advantages, disadvantages, option one, and option two, advantages and disadvantages. And then the third one, your choice. Okay, your decision. So one mark, 5 marks. That's how we get the marks. Okay, option one, we tell advantages and disadvantages. Option two, we tell the advantages, disadvantages, and then your choice. You choose which one, then you will get another 1 mark. Okay, first one, we start with ordinary share. So I want to talk about ordinary share. I go here, I write ordinary share. Okay, I want to do in paragraph. Okay, ordinary share, you can talk about advantages. What is the advantages of ordinary share? What is the advantages of the ordinary share? You can talk about dividend. Okay, the dividend vary according to the profit. So the company will no, the company will pay dividend only if the company make profit. There is no agreement to pay dividend. So what I'm trying to say is, here is, you only pay the dividend. You only pay the dividend whenever you get a profit. You only pay the dividend whenever you only get a profit. Whenever you don't have a profit, you don't need to pay the dividend. So you are. This is like advantages for us for this. Okay. Then second one is, I continue. But you can continue about the disadvantage. Advantages, you can talk about. It may take longer. It may take longer to raise the fund. So if you want to issue an ordinary share, it takes time. You need to follow some procedures to take the issue the ordinary share from the public, and then the public back. Take time to raise the fund. Okay. Next one, I want to talk about bank loan. So bank loan, the advantages of the bank loan. If you take a bank loan, it is easier to obtain the fund. So since we are limited company, so whenever we apply loan, it's easy to get a loan. But a fixed rate of interest, needs to be paid each year, regardless the company make profit or not. Okay, if the company make profit or the company make a loss, you still need to pay the interest. But just now, the ordinary share, if the company make profit, then we pay. The company didn't make profit, we no need to pay. That's the advantages of the ordinary share. Disadvantages of the bank loan, don't care, regardless you get a profit or loss, you still need to pay the interest. Okay, advise the directors on which two methods more appropriate. So can you tell me? It's your answer. Both answers are acceptable. You can say ordinary share, or you can say bank loan. Okay, so I go for ordinary share. I might say the appropriate method will be ordinary share because it's don't increase the liability for the company. So because if your liability, if you have a lot of liability, then it's not good for the company, right? So that's why I choose ordinary share. So I don't need, my liability will be on control. Okay, that's it for question number two. We are done with the question number two. Okay, we will continue with the question number three tomorrow. Thank you so much. Please love accounts. Accounts will love you back.